For years, we've been wondering when all the games and minutes would finally catch up to LeBron James. And for years, right up until this season, whenever Father Time seemed to gain enough ground to appear in his rearview mirror, LeBron managed to pick up the pace. But even basketball immortals are still mortal. And based on the pattern we've seen developing in LA, it's time to admit that LeBron, while still awesome, is now a star in decline. And this Lakers team isn't built to withstand that. James has been an historic anomaly, reigning over the NBA deep into his second decade in the league. It's not that he hadn't experienced any decline since his absolute apex, but the physical falloff was always minor enough that he could account for it with skill progression and an absolute mental mastery of the game. He appeared to be slowing down as long ago as his first season back in Cleveland in 2014-15. But midway through that campaign, he took 2 weeks off to go to Miami and rehab his ailing back. He returned like a man on fire, ultimately dragging the Cavs to within 2 wins of the championship without Kyrie Irving or Kevin Love. He helped topple the 73-win Warriors with an unfathomable finals performance the following year, then led the Cavs and a shoddier supporting cast through the East in the next 2 years, making it 8 straight finals trips overall. Even as Cleveland got swept by Golden State in 2018, LeBron staked his claim as the best player alive with a Herculean effort in Game 1 that ranks among the greatest individual playoff performances ever. Cue J.R. Smith.
Hill misses. Rebound goes to the Cavs. J.R. Smith brings it back out. Throws it to Hill. Hill shot blocked. And we'll go to overtime.
His first season with the Lakers in 2018-19 looked like the beginning of the decline, as LeBron struggled to gel with his young teammates, looked downright disinterested at the defensive end, suffered a groin strain that led to the first extended injury absence of his career, and missed the playoffs for the first time in 14 years. But then the Lakers traded for Anthony Davis, and a rejuvenated LeBron recommitted to defense. By season's end, he was hoisting the Larry O'Brien and Bill Russell Finals MVP trophies in Disney World, demanding his respect after once again establishing himself as the NBA's top dog. James spent that championship season openly mocking the idea of him being washed, even though no one had really said that. And he obviously got the last laugh that year. But when it comes to his Lakers tenure, it now seems that title-winning campaign was the blip, and his debut season might have been something closer to the norm. Another injury-plagued campaign followed in 2020-2021. Still, when he was healthy, LeBron was tremendous, and the Lakers continued to dominate when both James and Davis were on the court, including in a playoff series loss to Phoenix. The Lakers had the eventual West champions on the ropes before Davis got injured. And despite LeBron's own disappointing and hobbled finish to that series, it was still easy to talk yourself into considering a fully healthy and locked in LeBron as the best player in the league. But now in year 19, as he approaches his 37th birthday, with more than 61,000 regular season and playoff minutes to his name, it's become more difficult to make that case. At this point, the notion of a fully healthy LeBron feels increasingly unrealistic, and his play when he's been available hasn't come close to best player in the league caliber. LeBron missed 12 of the Lakers' first 23 games this season, 2 due to an ankle sprain, 1 due to suspension, 8 due to an abdominal strain, and 1 due to a false positive COVID-19 test. He's now missed as many games during 3 1/4 seasons in Los Angeles as he did in his first 15 years combined.
That was half a lifetime ago. We're different people now.
This, as much as anything, is what age catching up to a player looks like. Nicks and bruises become harder to play through. Recoveries take longer, and absences lead to more absences. But LeBron's play, even when he's been healthy enough to take the floor, has also been well below his usual standard. His vertical and horizontal bursts have both looked diminished, and he hasn't displayed the turn-the-corner explosiveness that in past years allowed him to get downhill consistently. As a result, he's averaging by far the lowest free throw rates of his career, and is more reliant on his jump shot than ever before. Above the break threes now account for more of his field goal attempts than shots at the rim do, which hadn't even been remotely close to happening in any previous LeBron season. He's gone from taking 46% of his shots at the rim during the Lakers' championship campaign just 2 years ago to 35% this season. He's taking more pull-up threes than ever, despite hitting just 26% of them. When he's handling the ball in the pick and roll, he'll often avoid opportunities to take an extra dribble toward the basket that might help open up a pass, instead opting to get off the ball early, shoot a step back, or pull the ball back out to go to work against the switch. And the types of players he used to wreck on switches now appear plenty capable of holding their own against them, even slow-footed bigs. Now, in his defense, the Lakers' lack of floor spacing means multiple defenders often await LeBron should he choose to drive. LeBron's rebound rate is also a career low. You can chalk some of that up to him frequently playing next to the league's most aggressive rebounding guard in Russell Westbrook, along with two bigs. But that still doesn't explain why the Lakers rank bottom 7 in defensive rebound rate, and why they corral an even lower share of available boards with LeBron on the floor. The state of LeBron's defense is equally concerning. At LeBron's age, there is logic in scaling back at this part of the season for the sake of physical preservation. But there are possessions where he has multiple opportunities to help and simply chooses not to, even when doing so wouldn't seem to demand all that much energy. Much like on offense, the Lakers roster isn't really doing LeBron any favors here. The club gave away its two best point of attack defenders and one of its best forward defenders in the offseason, and is now relying on the likes of Westbrook, Malik Monk, Wayne Ellington, and Carmelo Anthony to contain penetration and make weak side rotations. No surprise then that the Lakers allow by far the highest opponent rim frequency in the league. Even with Davis beside him, LeBron simply isn't insulated the way he was the last two seasons. Even still, the Lakers have been 6 points per 100 possessions better defensively with him on the bench. And while they've still been better overall with LeBron on the floor, they've only played opponents to a dead draw in those minutes, while losing the minutes when James and Davis share the court.
That can't be right.
The fact that LeBron is in his decline phase and still averaging roughly 27, 7, and 6 on 59% true shooting tells you all you need to know about his greatness. There are plenty of all-stars who can only dream of ever having a prime season that good. It's just unfortunate that this Lakers team isn't built to withstand his decline. The team's questionable depth, shoddy perimeter defense, poor spacing, and ineffective half-court creation could really only be overcome by vintage LeBron. And that guy isn't walking through the door. It's telling how much the Lakers still depend on James that even in his aging and hobbled state, they've played him nearly 37 minutes a game.
I'm tired, boss.
He's still a top 10 player in basketball, maybe even top 5 at close to full health and peak playoff intensity. But he may no longer be the type of franchise carrier who can overcome all roster flaws by sheer force of will. Unfortunately, that's what the Lakers need him to be in order to accomplish anything meaningful this season. And unless James has one last squirreled away stash of the magic elixir he found midway through the 2014-15 campaign and in the 2019 offseason, the Lakers' hopes of making it through multiple playoff rounds, let alone escaping the West or hanging banner number 18, are doomed. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and want to see more content like this, be sure to hit that subscribe button.